Hey everyone, so I just got a parcel delivered to my house. It's from Japan. So if you've been watching my videos, you probably have an idea of what is going to be in here. And I'm so excited. And I know that I should have kept my makeup on this morning because I already filmed a video prior to this, which was my styling my boyfriend jeans. Okay, now I'm too excited to care about people judging me for what I look like on camera. I don't give a shit. So I'm just gonna go ahead and open this, do an unboxing so you guys can see it with me and you can see my reaction, because this is exciting for me. I think I need to get this thing off of it first. Okay. Should be able to just cut through, right? Maybe. We'll see. Oh, this one is taking a long time. Here we go. Ah, there. Used my strength. Okay, there's an invoice inside, and if you can tell what it says, it is a Louis Vuitton bag. This is going to be my first confirmed authentic Louis Vuitton bag, and they sent it with a big box, which I really appreciate, because my Fendi and my Marc Jacobs ones were sent in just like a normal parcel, just bubble wrap. This one came in a box. And let me go ahead. I paid under 250 Australian dollars for this, because this one is like really old. I mean, you can tell. And it's funny because I wasn't even like planning on buying one. Well, I was. I've been looking at Louis Vuitton bags from Japan for a long time. If you have not heard, Japan is very strict with their secondhand market. They don't sell counterfeit items, so you can be assured that these are authentic. Now this was up for bidding, and there was like 5 minutes left to the bidding when I found it. Oh, maybe even less than that, because like I quickly searched through the photos, looked at whether or not this bag is genuine, and looked at what they said about like the flaws in it. And so, and like within like 5 seconds I was bidding and I won. So yeah, I think I paid like something like 232 Australian dollars for this, and it's here now. So you can tell, well, because it is so cheap, you can tell that there's a lot of flaws. So you can like, you look at the zips on here, you can see that there's a lot of like rusting on it. I'm gonna try and see if using a metal polish would help with that. It would probably help with the zips, because like the zipper you can see is actually quite old already. And the handles are like really old now, and I can tell some green things happening like where the handle and the brass hits. You can also see like the rivets that are like really old. The bottom is also quite old and like stained. There's loads of water stains. I wonder if this was in a flood, because it also smells a bit like the leather got wet, but the zipper works pretty well. Okay, they also have this stuffing inside, which I'm gonna keep to keep this. And there is like a, I think this is a desiccant. It's a desiccant, so it absorbs moisture. There is your pocket. And then so far inside, the inside is actually quite nice. There are no damages, a few stains here and there, but nothing that is nothing that would make me want to not use the bag. And here you will see the tag, the date code, where it says VI0963. So this bag is from 1993, so that's what, 26 years old. Okay, 06 1993, so June of 1993. I'm gonna have to condition the leather on this, and but it still looks quite good. There are no cracks on the canvas as far as I can tell. I'm gonna have to like really look through this. Yeah, but that's okay. And I did order some leather paint from the brand Angelus. I'm just waiting on that. I ordered the Vachetta shade because I intend to paint this. But before I do that, I'm actually gonna clean it up and then see if I could actually remove some of the dirt on here and make it look prettier before I decide on whether I will actually paint it. Yes. Okay, so I just did a quick wipe down of the bag, and this rag was like that. The part where I used is now like that. So that's how dirty it was. I'm gonna let it dry and then I'm gonna do another wipe down. So this rag is damp. I'm gonna do another wipe down, but I can already tell that the handles came out a little bit better after I cleaned it, because it was really dark at the start. I bet you, because so what happens when you clean it, because this is damp, it looks darker once because it's wet, but then once it dries, it's going to look a little bit cleaner. There was a lot of like brown stuff on here. You can still see it. See? Yeah. So I'm gonna go ahead and clean that up. And then once my leather, what do you call this? Once my leather paint comes, I am going to show you what I'm going to do in order to clean this thing up and make it look new again by painting it with the Vachetta color, which was the original color of this leather here. Okay, I don't actually mind how it's already a honey shade of patina. I might have just to condition all the letters. I don't know when that's going to arrive, so what I'll probably do is clean this up, clean the brass, and then condition the leather. Okay, at least with the wipe down, the dust and all the like minor dirts that can be removed has been removed. Okay, wow, that's a lot. See, it's turning brown. Okay, all right. Yeah, so that's my unboxing. The second part of this video, I'm going to show you how I'm going to condition this. It's very, very simple, really. So one of the flaws that I've seen is that some of the stitching are starting to unravel, but it's okay. It's not that bad. Yeah, and the brass, I'm gonna clean that up. And there's a little bit of, it's almost like the leather is chipped a little bit. You see those white specks? So it's already like dried pretty much after I've done a wipe down. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to apply, this is my Doc Martens Wonder Balsam. This works really well for my shoes and I've used it in my other bags. So I'm going to use this to condition the leather and let it to dry. And then after that, once it's dried overnight, I'm going to go ahead and use this. I got this from Status Anxiety, which is a bag or a leather goods brand here in Australia, and this is their Aqua Seal, which is a conditioner and a preserver of leather. So now when I, because this Wonder Balsam, it looks like there's not much in there, but you only need a little bit really. So I've been using it with all of my Doc Martens and all of my bags, and it comes with this little sponge, which is the applicator that I use for this. So you can just take a little bit on that, and that should be enough for one side of it. And I'm gonna start, and I'm just gonna go ahead and spread that all over. And you can already feel right away that it is absorbing. Okay, making sure I get all of the nooks and crannies there. I'm taking care not to pull too much because the leather is quite sensitive. Some of it has dried a little bit, but they're still okay. So if you need more, just take more. There, okay, gotta make sure that the sides are all done, even this one's in the insides. Actually, that one I need to clean first with a damp cloth. Same for the other side because it's all like dusty from being in storage. I'm gonna put in the in the comment section or the description box below the name of the company that I bought this from. Okay, so it was a pretty quick bidding. And I was like, okay, maybe I was, because what I really wanted to get was the Speedy Damier Azure, the white one. That's what I really wanted to get, and that's what I was looking for. But then I saw this, and I think it was more of an impulsive buy because I was like, oh shit, 5 minutes left from the bidding. And I can't tell you how many times I have bid on an item and lost at the last 10 seconds because somebody's like waiting for the very last seconds before they put in their final bid, and I was outbid. It was for a Louis Vuitton puzzle bag, and that really broke my heart because I really wanted the bag, but it's okay. Okay, so I have conditioned here. Now I'm gonna do the bottom. I'm gonna condition this even though I'm thinking of painting it because, well, it would still need to be a good quality leather before I paint it. And I mean, now that I've seen this, I'm not even sure if I actually wanna paint it. Because it's not bad, actually. Well, it looks used, but, well, it is, that's because it is used. Yeah, so I don't really mind the honey color. That's what I want the patina of my Louis Vuitton to be like if I had bought a new one. So I don't mind this at all. Okay, so it's gotten its Wonder Balsam. I'm just making sure that I've touched on everything by feeling it, whether it's got conditioning or not. Yeah. Okay, that's done. I'm gonna go into that little corner that I left behind earlier. Make sure I get into the depths of it. Okay. There we go. Now on to the handles. This is especially important to do when you see that your leather is already drying out. You might reconsider if there are already cracks in the leather, because you don't want to aggravate that one. Okay, so done. And I'm gonna make sure that I do it for especially the sections here where the hardware is on, because you want that to be supple as well, and to take care of that, because that's where most of your wear and tear would be. I've seen so many Louis Vuittons where this cracks and the handles break. So I don't want that to happen to this, even though this is already 26 years old. Okay, I still want it to be treated as if it's new and to last me a long time. Okay. Can already feel it being really nice and smooth. I wonder if this could be an ASMR video, because you can hear me scrubbing away. Okay. I have now gone over the whole of it, so they're all, it's a little bit of a green bit in here. I don't know what that is. I think it came from like that little bit of green from the handle. Okay. Yeah. So now I'm gonna let the leather rest, but what I'm going to do now is go ahead and clean the rivets and the hardware with a brass cleaner. Okay, so now I've got Brasso here, which is a metal polish. Make sure you shake it up. I've got some Q-tips as well. If I can open it, there. So I'm just going to dip the Q-tip onto the solution. Actually, there's a little bit here on the cap, so I'm just gonna use that. And I'm going to gently put that on the rivet. And leave it on for a little bit. And hopefully that helps to clean that up. Okay, might not have been enough. I need a little bit more. Just going to do that. Clean that part. Be careful not to let that metal polish go onto your leather, although it's not that big of a deal. And then I'm taking the same cloth that I used for cleaning the bag, and just going over the rivets like so. I don't know if you can tell the difference between this and this, but that to me looks much better than earlier. And you can see the dirt on that little bit of it. So since that leather part has gotten damp again, I'm gonna go back to that later and reapply some more balsam wonder on it, or wonder balsam. I'm also trying to get rid of those little green bits around the rivets, because they're not supposed to be there. OK. Okay, I don't know what they are, but it's like discoloration or accumulation of whatever. So I am removing that. Okay. And I'm gonna add a little bit more of this. So a couple of layers over. And I'll just repeat the process for the other side as well as the sides here. Actually, I'll show you one of the handle bars. Let's see how that will work. If it's gonna work, it's magic. Okay, I'm just gonna put some more here. Leave it for a little bit for it to work its magic. Okay, now I'm going to clean this part up. Didn't change it much. I guess it made it a little bit cleaner, this side here versus that side. I don't know if you can tell the difference, but that's fine. But my rivets are definitely much better. And look at that one here versus the one here in the back. That's the before, that's the after. Yep, definitely worth the effort. Okay, so now that I have done the cleaning of the brass, I am now going to use the aqua seal. And I'm hoping you can see it from there. Maybe I'll take off these other stuff here because I've got this hanging here and it says to put it about 6 inches away, shake well. Okay. So it's all like pretty wet at the moment. Am I supposed to wipe that on? Leather should be free of debris holding. Sprayer 6 inches away, apply an even coat to the surface, apply a second coat after an hour, let dry overnight. Okay, so I think we're good with this side. Just want to make sure that. Then I'm going to go and actually I should spray it with. Making sure that I've got all that areas sorted as well. Okay, then I am going to flip this over, other side, and then and then bottom. Now I'm taking a clean cloth rag and I'm just gonna wipe over both sides. Making sure that I spread it evenly. Bottom as well. the patinas at the bottom, the handles. And as you can see, it has turned a little bit dark, like the patina, but that's okay because that's going to readjust to its natural color afterwards. Okay, wipe through. Make sure you get onto the handles. Okay, and then I'm just gonna keep that hanging overnight so that it dries evenly. And now my Louis Vuitton looks clean and perfect. Well, not perfect, it still has its flaws, but at least it is much better than when I received it this morning. Okay, I'll leave that alone now. And that's it for my unboxing and my cleaning. I'll show you the final one once it's dried off tomorrow. See you then. Okay, so 24 hours later, this is what the bag looks like now with it being conditioned and cleaned. So it looks much, much better. I am still contemplating on whether I would want to paint the handles and the bottom with Vachetta. That's the shade of the Angelus leather paint that I bought. Just because this looks really old and dated with its honey patina. But I'm concerned that if I paint it with that Vachetta shade, it would look rather weird, because then it would look like everything else is new except the actual like body of the bag. But anyway, I'm pretty happy with how this turned out. It looks really nice and clean. I did overdo it with the brasso on the zips, and you can see there's like white marks on it, but I'm gonna go ahead and put some oil on there, like a WD-40, to also make it easier for the zips to open, and hopefully that will remove those white specks. But yeah, that's what the bag looks like now. Awesome, right?